I'm Van.
I'm Sori.
That's Lobby.
And Salty and Chip.
So, we're technically still millennials. We're like just under the
thing. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, are you happy or not?
This one's going to be Millennials Reactor Queen.
It's a bit of a stretch. But how can it... But I'm not sure... This is not a true reaction for me because I've heard pieces of this song before.
Yeah, everybody has heard piece of this song.
Oh, okay.
But we've never actually looked at the lyrics and all that.
No, and I've not, like, heard the whole song. I just heard the chorus.
I think... You know what I think? I think most people have heard the... Wee! But they have never heard anything else.
Yeah.
I think this is probably going to be the first time that people ever actually, like... hear what the actual lyrics are saying. See what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. I remember when we were kids, my sister, I'm pretty sure it was my sister, she started singing it. Like, anytime that she wanted to be, like, whatever, like, she would, I'd be like, oh, don't say that! We will
wanted
rock
to be
you.
What? Like a badass?
Yeah, I think a little bit. Like, maybe not listen, so we will. We
you ought to repent, Chris.
Rock you.
Talking about rocking people. Fuck is wrong with you? Okay. Alright, well... So, that's that. This is Queen. The name of the band is Queen. You know what inspired this was we saw a commercial for the movie.
Yeah.
So.
And I was like, I heard it, and I'm like, hey.
We were in some neighborhood.
Well, I liked that he
in
said...
In Biddeford.
What?
We were in some neighborhood in Biddeford, Maine.
Yeah?
Yeah, that was before the accident and everything. And everybody was doing that. People really felt like badasses when they were doing it, too.
They're yeah. You know, when I used to hear it, we would go to baseball games and they would play to the baseball game. And everybody would start stomping, stomp, stomp,
yeah.
clap, stomp. And
yeah.
I was like, that was, I was a little bored by the baseball games, but I always looked forward to that part of it. Like the everybody doing the same thing or throw up the wave or get the hot dog. I mean, I'm good with
that. Yeah,
that
must be, some crazy shit to play in, like in front of a bunch of people, which is what we're about to see.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah,
we will
live. I want to see the live version.
Motherfucker. All right, let's do it.
All right.
Shout out to the big homie, Charlie Moon.
Yeah. I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Glad you enjoyed your shirt, girl.
Limited edition.
Only one.
Yep, you're the only one.
Ever.
Okay, ready?
So how you do it?
I like this, baby. But yours is cute, too. Okay, ready?
All right, let's do it.
Get your things in.
Oh. Go!
Go.
Yeah.
That was it?
Yeah. You know
what? What was that?
First of all, what?
That was it?
Yeah, I know. They should have just like, gotten it a couple more times. Yeah. I, honest to goodness, I really, really like that song. And I like his voice, too.
Yeah.
What were we singing about?
Well, it seemed to be like the progression of age. Buddy, you're a boy. Make a big noise. Playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place.
Yeah.
So he's just a little kid. Then the next one is, buddy, you're a young man, hard man. Shouting out in the street. Gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, you big disgrace. Waving your banner all over the place.
Uh-huh.
Right? Then, buddy, you're an old man, poor man. Pleading with your eyes. Gonna make you some peace someday. You got mud on your face, big disgrace.
So you're just gonna suck your. So your whole life you're gonna be disgraced.
Well,
and what's the "We Will Rock You" part?
It's what society. It's what society is saying.
Oh, and then they're saying "we," as in because we're all being said like that we're a disgrace. We're gonna say we're gonna like rock the world.
Well, I mean, it might be society saying we're gonna rock you and fuck you up for daring to be an individual or daring to have dreams or whatever.
Oh yikes! Okay.
And then or the it might be. Because it's somebody's talking to the kid in the singular, and then it's a we.
Yeah.
So it might be.
I think it's society's response.
It's society responding to the person, but it also might be the person saying, no, like, we're going to use rock music as our outlet to. We're going to use rock music as in our outlet to rebel or whatever. So whether you're a little kid or you're a grown man, you know, you're young, like at the peak of your powers, hard man. You know, or you're an old man.
Mm-hmm.
Same kid. He grows up, and then he's an old man, poor man. We kind of talked about it in what do you call it? The us and them thing,
mm-hmm.
where the guy goes off to Vietnam or whatever.
Oh, yep. Mm-hmm.
I'm assuming it's Vietnam because it was in the 70s. So, I think that's the point of the song, is that progression.
Okay. I like it. Now, it's funny that they play it at different, like I said, it was at the baseball game, or it's just, but it's a good crowd song.
Well, the We Will Rock You, like, is kind of like, everybody's like, yeah, we're gonna rock you.
Mm-hmm.
But if we're right in a society saying that, then that's probably like the most misunderstood lyric
of all
time.
No, because I don't agree with you that that's what it's saying. That's what you're saying. I'm saying,
so if I'm
society
right.
is saying, verse 1, verse 2, verse 3, but the we will rock you is everybody as a collective saying, hey, wait a minute, what the fuck? They've been saying that to me too. Oh, they've been saying that to me. Oh, yeah, well, we're going to rock you with our rock music. We're going to do, you know what I mean? Like, and this was a huge song. This is like a huge hit. So I think it's that, you know, they're not fitting into those boxes that people made for them and said that they're just going to be a disgrace, whatever. Like, I'm just a little kid that's kicking my can around, like,
kicking
I'm
your something that's gonna... can all over the place, singing.
Yeah,
the kid
there we
is
go.
Singing,
yeah.
We Will Rock You. So maybe he's speaking for himself and his friends.
Yeah.
So.
No, what did you think of his costume when he came out? I'm like, it's a different time. The shirt all open, going around. It's just a different time, you know?
I don't give a fuck what time it was.
You know what, though? But I think that time,
I do not care.
I bet the girls were falling all over that
shit.
Oh,
I'm sure. Well, I mean.
What?
Freddie Mercury, I mean, he was gay.
Oh, well, I mean, okay. Well, then the gentlemen were falling all over that shit.
Oh, I'm sure. Well, there was a couple times when he was strutting and he was like, I'm a bad motherfucker. And it was clear that he thought he was a bad motherfucker.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
So it's like, Charlie, don't say that word. So it's like, you know, like, he had the stage presence.
Yes.
The cape thing was too much for me.
You was a little bit.
Cape.
But
nah,
I feel like for that time, I could throw in a bit, and I loved it. It was like added some drama to it, and he was entertaining to watch.
There are just some people that are just born to be on a stage.
Yes, yeah. You remember when we were watching Iced Earth? Like, which song was that?
Yeah, Barlow.
He was just like, he had the same, like, he was good with himself. Like, he was like, we used to say, like, some people walk around like they're God's gift to women. You know what I mean? Like, we still.
Yeah.
Well, this gentleman was a little bit different because, you know, he didn't really want the women. But anyway, you get the idea.
I like when a rock star gets on stage, though, and does
that. And has that kind
like,
of an attitude.
Listen.
Yep.
You know,
I think the only
Corey used to do that from Slipknot. He used to stalk around on the stage and be like this.
Yeah.
In reality, he's shorter than me. But on stage, he's larger than life.
Right, that's true.
So he's just, you know.
Hey. I feel like, I think the only other person, okay, from my opinion, the only ones that I've seen that I'm like, okay, they're very comfortable with themselves and they really think that they're the shit is the Iced Earth guy. What's his name?
Matthew Barlow.
Him, this guy.
Jonathan, big homie.
And Floor. Those three. Like the
Floor?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. When she's up there and she's like going all around, you're like, she's like, nobody's my equal, please.
Yeah. Yeah. That's true. But there's nobody like this dude. I've never seen nothing like that in my life. What the fuck was that?
Oh, my word. I'm going to rewatch his reaction just so I can see your face.
Somebody sat down and said, yo, I'm going to rock this cape. So
yep. I'm going to go in front of that fan.
I'm
going
to go with this cape.
I'm going to go with this
shirt.
The belt thing was open.
Flowing and shit. That's one of those things where it's like, only he can do that. Like, you can't do... Well, Freddy does. You're not Freddy.
No. Right? No. I... Honest to goodness,
I'm Sam from Nebraska.
Yeah.
You can't do that shit.
Please. And you shouldn't have your
shirt
on. Fuck
your feelings. Yeah, like, he... I just feel like... Yeah, like, that's a real... He was really strutting, like, man...
Yeah.
Yeah, but I, you know, like, that's a dude. Maybe he was fronting or whatever, but he really looked like he was just like, yo, this is me, dude.
Yeah. Like, yeah, no, I'm saying, like, some people just, they're very comfortable with themselves, and I think that, you know.
I had this friend that I used to work with. His name was Mike, you know.
Yeah.
And you know, I mean, Mike is gay as hell, you know, and we're in, you know, our site was in the downtown area, and a lot of, you know, dudes that think they're thugs and they're really not thugs at all, but Mike, you know, we'd have to fire people.
Yeah.
And this dude one time tried to take Mike outside. He's like, oh, let's sip outside. I was like, motherfucker. I was like, let's go outside. Let's go right now.
Yeah.
And right now. Yeah. Yeah, but Mike is like that. I still see him like walking around time to time. Like,
oh, really?
Yeah. Like, that was my guy. We were like two peas in a pod.
Yeah.
That was my dude. And he just didn't care. What did I tell you about that time? One time we went to fire that girl?
Oh, I was thinking of another story. Go ahead. What happened?
And so we were on a certain campaign. I can't mention it, but there's another campaign called City. Mm-hmm. And so... We were managing one campaign, so we're taking this girl to the office to fire her, and she goes, yeah, you know, I've been thinking about going to City. Uh-huh.
But you were on the way to fire her?
We were on the way to fire her, so Mike points to the door. He goes, there's a big city out there!
Oh, no!
She looked at me horrified. I said, just give me your badge.
A big city out there.
He couldn't help himself. Shout out to the big homie.
Oh man. You remember that? Where was that?
It's a cold world, man.
Was that? Remember our friend?
You should have done that shit, man.
The person would play that song that another one bites the dust.
Yeah.
When they fire somebody.
Yeah.
You can't do that.
That's actually by this band.
Really?
Why? It's by this band. I'm pretty sure.
I think that the country people redid it. I think that's the only version I've heard.
There's no way to countryize that song.
No.
That's an abomination.
I think they may have, though.
No, God would destroy the entire country genre if they tried to do that. Destroy them all. Yeah, but the big homie, Mike was like that. He was fabulous, but he dominated the room.
Yeah.
He dominated the area. Like,
he did?
Yeah, you didn't fuck with Mike. People used to come and be like, yo, man, I'm on Mike's team. Am I going to be in trouble? Really? I'm like, yeah, you're going to be in a lot of trouble. Don't fuck with Mike. Don't fuck with his money.
Go to the city.
Mike will fuck you up. You better listen to what he has to say. It's like this, that. This dude was like, I just can't believe it. Like,
I just can't believe it.
I just imagine being God. Like, there's my guy.
Yep.
There he is with his cape.
Yep.
And Del will be like, he's got a cape.
There's
I'll be like, so are you. You have a cape too.
Like that.
You have a cape too. You know? Only you're bad. So shut up. Who? Dorian would rock a cape.
Dorian would do
and
it.
Zoe
and Zoe
would.
Both of them. And they'd be up there thinking, that's it.
If Zoe felt like that, like, I want to rock a cape, she would do it.
Yep.
She would be like, fuck this. I want to wear this cape. I don't care what you motherfuckers say.
Yep.
And she'd be like, don't copy me either. That's what she would do. Don't copy me.
Yeah, she's an original thinker, so I would always copy my older sister. Because everything she always did always looked better than mine, so I'd copy her. And she used to get so mad. Oh, my word. It was really frustrating. She couldn't have anything original because they were copying off.
Yeah, the big homie, Freddie Mercury, he's with the Ain't Self now.
Oh, that guy?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
What
happened? Yeah,
he was a casualty of the whole AIDS crisis thing.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Sad story, but... Because I know we're going to go see the movie, and I didn't want you to get all shocked and cry and shit in the theater. But,
oh, yeah. Well, I mean, I think I'm still going to be sad, babe, when it happens. But I'm glad you forewarned me.
Yeah.
Because I thought, you know, I thought he was still...
I just... It's a very strange thing to me when I see people, and I just think to myself, God must have really loved this guy. You know, like, it's weird to me. Like, and I love him because I know that God loved him first.
Yeah.
You know, that's
how. But the thing is, like, you're looking at somebody who, like, the world is like, hey, wow, we love this guy. But there's like other people that like, people are just so like unique in their own ways. Like, you know that there's that. I think he's a buddy of the Metal Elitist. And you put him on sometime. You know who I'm talking about? He's got the long hair. He'll be in like these weird rooms sometimes. Like,
Metal Ben. Yeah.
Like him. Like when I watch his stuff, I'm like, that's, you know what I mean? Like you can just feel like, oh, I think God loves that guy.
Yeah.
You know, he's putting his best out there.
Yeah.
What's the name of it? The Metal Band?
No. It's Metal Ben. Metal Ben's Chronicles, I think.
Metal Ben's Chronicles. You should check him out.
Check out the big homie. What do you give the song?
Oh, 10. I really liked it.
It's a classic song. It's a 10. It was going to get a 9.5, but the cape put it at 0.5.
The cape put it up?
The fact that he had the cojones to walk out there with a cape like that and be serious.
Yeah, and it was white.
Because he was serious. Right? He was serious as hell. He wasn't laughing. He was like, look, motherfucker, it's the cape.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. We should have the kids come in here and watch that with us.
Yeah, we should have. We should have them do the...
Let's call him in right now. Look, we're short. We're only 18 minutes.
Yeah, bring him in. Babe, this computer's not on yet. What'd you do?
No, it's on. Are you kidding me?
Fail again.
What the fuck?
La.
Okay.
All right, well, we're back.
The whole crew.
Somebody had the bright idea to bring these terrorists in here. All right, kids, look. First of all, so here it is. This is a band called Queen, and there's a song called We Will Rock You, and we want you guys to give us your honest opinion. You ready?
You gotta watch. Though we watch.
Thank you.
why?
Ridiculous. Okay. Oh, I like the other version. This live version is terrible.
I know.
What's wrong with
it? Okay, one at a time.
I could bear it, but I don't like it.
Why don't you like it?
Because it's weird.
What's
it's
weird?
Very short. The guy looks weird.
What do you mean he looks weird? What guy?
He's showing his clothes. He's showing his clothes. A clean armpit.
Sayla, what did you think of it?
Why would his shirt almost be off? It's weird to me, and I hate the song.
You hate the song.
The studio version was much better than the live version.
What did you think of the singer?
Oh my god. The live version sucks.
That's so disgusting. I can't tell you how disgusted I am.
So deeply poo on that. Terrible.
Oh, what? Oh, Zoe.
You didn't like the music? What did you think of the singer?
Wait, what about Johan? You didn't like it either?
I didn't really know much of the lyrics. I couldn't really...
What about the part where he was saying,
What did you think of the singer when he walked out? Why were you laughing?
Yeah, what was all that laughing about?
He showed a close-up thing of his armpit.
What did you think of his cape? I thought his cape was fabulous. What about you?
Really? It was funny.
What if I walked out? Kids have those like little superhero capes.
Yeah.
That's what it looks like.
Well, what if I came out with a superhero cape like that?
It'd be hilarious.
If I came out all fabulous like that, you guys, what would you guys think?
I'd probably laugh, and I'd think you were weird.
Okay. What do you give the song 1 to 10?
A zero. It shouldn't be there.
Zero. Allahu Akbar. All right, what about you?
Three.
A three. What about you, Dorian?
Zero. It's in the rating.
Seriously.
What about you, Johan?
Seven.
Seven. Yeah, there you go, buddy. All right, all of you are disappointments to me. Yep. Get out.
No, that's it. Do the actual recording. Don't do the live version.
They're all disappointments. Zoe, you look very nice, actually.
Live version. The live version.
What you do with your hair? You got some.
Don't watch the live version.
You got some like Mad Max thing going on here, Edman. Okay, thank you. Good day.
Seattle Seahawks.
Good day.
All right, you guys can say goodbye to the camera.
Seahawks.
The village. Bye. Say goodbye to the villagers.
Bye.
Bye.
Our kids obviously don't know anything about rock history.
Yeah. Oh, we're sorry.
You rock.
Shout out to your 12th man.
Daddy, I need to pass.
Okay, go pass then. Nobody's stopping you. Give Freddie Mercury a zero. Okay, go on. Go ahead. Okay?
All right, good
Nobody
day.
Nobody needs you with your zero given self. You don't know fabulous when you see it. That's why you are the way you are. With your Mad Max haircut. Look like you're off in some desert on a four-wheeler. All right, well.
The
kids have spoken.
Yep. So that was an average, what? I'm not going to average that.
We're not even going to give you an average. We're not even going to dignify that
zero,
with a response.
Zero,
how dare they?
Seven and...
Been out.
Sorry out.
Gone.